You can ride for fun or ride to be the fastest. And there's a rare breed of riders who do anything they want. The trial bikers. Ultimate control is what they're craving for. This 8-time world champion takes you on a journey you have never seen before. Don't miss Kenny Belaey's Bigtime Trial Adventure.
I still remember Hans Rey 10 years ago, he was appearing in a TV show with his trials bike. And from that moment I just knew that trials had more to offer than just hard workouts and competition riding. So I started to think about how could I do the same. I convinced some sponsors to help me out, and now, a couple of years later, I'm having the best time of my life. A good thing today is the whole scene on the internet with the street trials going on. Because street trials is a very accessible way to learn this sport, and many kids, they are very much attracted by this new hype, and I think for the future of trials it's the best thing that could happen.
Second episode, Ken is searching for the boundaries and future of street trials in London. Meet up with American bike legends like Dave Mirror, Aaron Chase and Jeff Lenoski, while trials and free ride pioneer Hans Rey takes us on a mountain bike expedition to Maui.
It's 5 a.m. in the morning and we're on our way to the biggest street trial meeting ever in London. We hope to meet up with some influential street riders who are giving trials a whole new dimension.
My name's Jack Meek and I'm 25 and I've been riding for 9 years. I come from Reading in the UK, which is very close to London, and I've organised a ride today.
This wouldn't be possible without every individual person here being so enthusiastic about bike trial and putting the effort into getting it. So give yourself a massive round of applause. All right.
everybody's come together. The natural riders have come out of the woods and they've come onto the streets, and you know, they're shocked by the amount of skill. I mean, Danny Macaskill's ripping lines today.
Hi, I'm Danny Macaskill. I'm 23 years old and I am from Edinburgh. I've been riding for 12 years. I kind of ride a sort of mix. I just like to kind of do a mix of kind of BMX and trials, kind of street, and just sort of roll about and have fun. If there's nobody watching me, I'd still do the same thing over and over. I still push myself just the same. So it's kind of, I don't need people watching to sort of make me do what I do, but if there's people doing it, it's fine by me kind of thing. So yeah, it's good.
The self-expression is slowly growing at the moment into being a rider that can ride street and ride natural at the same time. And I think it makes you a much happier rider, because if you go down one avenue only, it's you're being quite strict to yourself, and you can get to a certain point where you might get unhappy with the progress of your riding, because you lose skills in certain areas which both the opposites can pick up and join together.
Sort of real mix of two styles, and there's people that kind of blend the two. I tend to do sort of mainly one, which is kind of just rolling about, kind of BMX-y style moves. It's so accessible because you can just walk out your doorstep and you're right there. So.
I heard a lot about this more creative kind of trials riding, but after seeing it, I was even more enthusiastic about it. Street has a lot of potential to help us make the sport bigger and to create new moves, because in the competition scene where I come from, it's only about performance, endurance and getting in shape.
The riding is amazing because everybody's bouncing off each other. You've got the younger generation of the riders bouncing off each other, but then they're bouncing off the professional riders thinking, I'm one day going to ride as good as that. But then the professional riders are bouncing off the UK riders, and like Kenny Belaey today did a huge gap, and it's something that I've really wanted to do myself, but I've never had the confidence, and that inspired me to then go and do it.
Today was incredible. I really enjoyed London. There was an endless amount of spots to shred, and something I noticed was the relaxed vibe amongst the street riders, since I'm used to hang around in a more competitive atmosphere. Maybe it's time to travel the globe and see how things progress on the other side of the ocean.
We're now in Cleveland, Ohio, in front of Race MTB Mountain Bike Park. It's the biggest indoor mountain bike park of the world. Today's Legends Weekend, so I'm going to meet riders like Jeff Vanoski, Dave Mira, Aaron Chase, Hans Rey, and many others. Let's have a look inside.
Coming to Race Indoor Mountain Bike Park is always amazing. I've been here now 4 or 5 times. It's always changing, it's always expanding. You see all these different riders, from the top pro riders to beginners, fathers with their kids, girls, you see BMX riders, you see cross-country riders, you see dirt jumpers, you know, you see it all, and they all have fun. Every city in the world should have a park like this.
Hey, how are you doing? My name is Aaron Chase. I'm 30 years old from Vernon, New Jersey, and I'm a freeride mountain biker. Trials is really like the base of technical riding. It's as technical as it gets, and I think everybody draws a little bit of influence from it, even from jumping or riding skate parks when you're doing wall rides or tire tapping. It's just basically precision bike control. I think a lot of guys get a lot of influence from trials.
I'm Dave Mira. I live in Greenville, North Carolina. I'm 34 years old and I ride BMX freestyle. Been pro for, well, since 92, so I guess it's like 16 or 17 years. Like a lot of us, I mean, I never thought it was gonna last even close to this long, to still be riding a bike and still making a living and still, it's just balancing on a big wave as long as you can.
Hey guys, what's going on? This is Mike Steadley and I'm a 7-time US National Trials Champion. So I've been riding about 10 or 12 years now and definitely some of the big influences are a lot of the European riders, but I would have to say the guys who really started off for me would be Hans Rey and Jeff Linoski.
I think the progress of trials is absolutely amazing. I mean, I started riding trials close to 20 years ago and pretty much my whole career we just did it on stock mountain bikes, and then seeing now what guys can do when they completely custom build a bike. The moves they do, it's totally amazing. It's stuff I never thought was possible. If you're a beginner, sport level rider, you can do it on any bikes.
It's really, really cool about evolution and in everybody's mind, how they see things a little bit different than when, you know, the guys before me, and then I saw things a little different, and they see things different. It just keeps going on and on.
So. Trials in the US is a little bit different than in Europe. We don't have quite as much competition. It's kind of based more on mixing in a little bit of free riding and North Shore riding.
What it's going to take to have trials in the X Games, I get scared that with all the motorized sports coming into X Games, are we, is BMX still going to be in the X Games? It's changing so much from what it used to be. I love the X Games. It's still a, you know, a huge platform. That's a good question.
We just need to get the exposure, get it in front of more people, because if they see it, they'll like it.
Kenny and his generation, they have taken it now to the new level. And even though this is not really a trials park here, there's a lot of lions you can find if you're a trials rider. And I think Kenny impressed a lot of people. And from here on, we're gonna head out back to California to my house for a night tomorrow. And then we're gonna go to Maui and I'm gonna take Kenny on a mountain bike adventure. So stay tuned.
You're watching Kenny Belaey's Big Time Trial Adventure.
It's strange trials isn't big time in the States, and there are almost no events in this huge country. Now I know how a pioneer like Hans must have felt some years ago.
I'm Hans Rey. We are here at my house in Laguna Beach in Southern California. I moved to America when I was 20 years old in 1987. And first I thought I'd just come here for a summer and kind of finish my trials riding career off, you know, before I retire. And little did I realize that my career was just about to start with the whole mountain biking boom. And fast forward 23 years, I'm here. I'm still a pro rider. And Kenny Belaey just came to visit me, and we're actually gonna go to Maui.
It's really crazy because Hans and I have many things in common. We both get to travel the world, discover new places, meet new cultures, and finally we get the chance to do a mountain bike and trials adventure together.
Last time I did it with him, it took us like 4 hours.
Yeah.
And what we did is I would just go ahead, me and him, and I'd say, okay, this would be a good spot, you know.
Today, Paul is taking us to the impressive 3,000 meter high volcano called Haleakala, which means House of the Sun. It's too bad the incredible views we were expecting are blocked by clouds. But on the other hand, it will add more drama to the pictures as we are shooting for the bike magazines. The lava rocks are extremely light and tricky, so the faster you ride, the better. But the last thing you want to do is crash into one of the craters. A small and technical single track led us into the forest where the trial skills came in handy. We planned to take it easy, but these trails challenge us to play a cat and mouse game. The Haleakala ride sure is one of the coolest downhills I've ever done. The next day, we finally found some sugarcane for Hans at the entrance of the legendary Twin Falls. According to our local photographer, there should be some nice trail spots at the waterfalls, but it's kind of a struggle to get there. It's nature at its finest over here, and it also shows there is more than beaches, surf and palm trees in Maui. I'm glad to ride my trial bike again on a natural course, since it has been a while and I hate to lose that feeling. A bunch of people who had no clue what we were doing followed us to the spot, and Hans, he showed me that he still masters his trial bike perfectly. Heard some rumors about the possibility to do some trials on the legendary beach of Jaws, a historical surf spot on Maui where the waves can reach heights of 20 meters and where jet skis are used to tow surfers into the waves. Huge rocks at the bottom of the cliff were perfect to train some of my big moves, which I will have to use later on in the competition season. So from now on, Jaws is not only a surf spot anymore. Because of Maui's microclimate, the weather changes very fast, so we had to escape from the rain. After a 20-minute drive, we arrived at the famous King's Highway. While we were riding this rough trail, some old trees beside this ancient lava field caught my attention and were great to finish the day on our trail bikes, at one of the most historical places on Maui.
Kenny, let's go! It's time for Pina Colada! Yeah!
Nice!
Sick!
The guide said he would keep the best for last, and he was absolutely right. This spot, called the Blowhole, at the west side of the island, with its raw power and massive splashes, is definitely the most epic spot I've ever ridden. After flying back to the States, I rented an RV and drove up north to the Sequoia National Park. I've read about big rocks and dangerous rivers, but what I found there was beyond expectations. After a long drive up the mountain, we finally entered the giant forest park. The surreal sequoia trees look like skyscrapers. It's just too crazy for words. A 2,000-year-old tree with an outline of 31 meters and measuring 84 meters is just massive. It's also the tallest tree on Earth and it's called General Sherman. Riding the slippery handrail was the only option I got because everything was covered by snow. It took me a while to get around this giant, but it sure is a ride you don't get to do on an ordinary day. There's a rise filled with rain. On my wings, yeah. The early evening brings. Jaded on my wings, yeah. The early evening sings. Trials sure is one of the basics of many other bike disciplines, whether it's street trials, mountain biking, or free riding. In the next episode, I'm going to show you all what really keeps me busy and what I work hard for every single day.
We are here live at Google Campus here in Mountain View, California.
We got 8-time world champion, Kenny Belaey, all the way from Belgium. He had a 24-hour flight here. He's one of our Red Bull athletes. He's a trial bike rider. Don't miss this show. It's going to be an amazing show. We'll see you, Kenny.